Is Resolve Color too complex and too slow? It can be, but it doesn't have to be. So let me show you some tips and tricks on how you can speed up your color workflow in DaVinci Resolve. I got the inspiration to make this video from a video by Matty Hapoya, where he was struggling with certain aspects of Resolve and switching to it from Final Cut Pro and Premiere. And one of the sections that he was struggling with was how to quickly and efficiently color a project in Resolve.
I do feel like it's a bit clunky and slow when you need to be super fast and super nimble.
This video is not meant to dunk on him or make him look stupid. I just figured if someone of his level and stature in filmmaking and YouTube is struggling with Resolve, then probably a lot more of you are as well. As far as I can tell from his video, his biggest problem with working in Resolve is his preferred method from Final Cut and Premiere Pro isn't available or isn't quite the same in Resolve as it is in those NLEs.
You just put an adjustment layer, figure out the look up there, and then you can just go through all the clips underneath that and tweak them a little bit, do the color correction, all that stuff.
So the first tip I want to show you is how to use adjustment clips in Resolve the same way that you do in Premiere and Final Cut Pro. This video is going to be broken down into what I'll call quick and dirty tips. So if you just want to get started, you don't want to do a lot of legwork in the front or organization, but you just have like a quick project and you just want to figure out how to copy grades or how to apply grades and apply corrections across whole groups of clips, across your entire timeline, across your entire project, I'm going to show you how to do that. And secondly, I want to show you how you can be a little bit more organized and how you can set up your project at the beginning so that when you do get to the color phase, that it actually works a lot more quickly and efficiently. The first quick and dirty method we're going to look at is using an adjustment clip or an adjustment layer. If you are used to Premiere Pro and Final Cut Pro, this might be the workflow that you're looking for. And it's very simple. It works exactly the same as those programs. Here in the Edit tab, come up to the top left and click on the Effects browser. Come down to the Effects dropdown. The very first item in the effects library is an adjustment clip. So you can just drag and drop that down onto your timeline. Once you have it down there, you can just drag it out over the entire timeline, like so. Very simple. Once you have it positioned how you want it, then just click on it, and then we're going to jump over into the color page. Your color page may not look like this by default, but that's okay. We have our row of clips. So these are all of the clips on the timeline, and you can toggle these thumbnails on and off by just hitting this button up here in the top left where it says clips. So there you go, on and off. Now there's also this timeline view. And I think this is the problem that Matty Hapoya is having with Resolve, in that when you come over to the color page, you lose the timeline view that you're used to working in. When you do color corrections and color grading in Premiere and Final Cut, you can still retain, you know, the timeline. You can really work out of the editing viewer if you want to. So it's very familiar. However, when you go into Resolve, by default, you don't have that timeline open. But again, it's very simple. Just come up to the top right hand side and then click this timeline. Now, this is a very compressed view of the timeline. It doesn't have the thumbnails anymore, but it's the same thing. You can easily navigate across your entire timeline. You can grab the playhead and just drag this around, or you can just click with your mouse over whatever section of the timeline that you want to work on. You can see that our adjustment clip here on video track 4 is highlighted. It's in red. That's the clip that we are going to work on. So if we do anything over here in this node, it's going to be applied to that adjustment clip. Whereas if you actually click on one of these clips, it will take a second, but then it will highlight that clip in red. And if we do any corrections over here in our node graph, it will only apply to that clip that is now selected. If you open up that clips viewer again, you can see that it's highlighted right there on that clip. But if we click on the adjustment clip again, it's going to jump to the beginning where that adjustment clip is. So now that's highlighted. And just to verify, in this node here that we have selected, it's highlighted on the adjustment clip. I'm going to drag the offset over to blue, and it's reflected right here on this little thumbnail. But if I click on any other clip in the timeline, you can see that it's been affected because it's underneath the adjustment clip. So that should be exactly the same as Premiere Pro and Final Cut Pro as far as how you work with adjustment clips. You just want to make sure that you do have the adjustment clip selected. If you click through on any of these thumbnails, it's going to select that clip. And then if you start making changes to it, it's only going to make changes to that clip. and not everything else. So just be careful. You're mindful of what you're actually selected on. All of these clips are in log. They're slog3, sgamut3.cine. They haven't been converted to Rec 709. So I'll just do a really quick conversion, just kind of a manual way, so you can see, you know, how it would work in practice. Come over to my curves and just make a really quick contrast adjustment using the curves. I come back over to my wheels and then just add a bunch of saturation and maybe some more contrast here. Looking at my vector scope, maybe that's a little bit off. We'll just kind of drag that with the offset down here. So whatever, probably not the best job, but just gives you an idea. So now if we go back over to the edit page and just play through this, all my clips have that correction applied to them because they're underneath that adjustment layer. If you need to chop up that adjustment clip, if you don't want that correction applied to your B-roll clips, for instance, you can easily just maneuver, you can just chop up that adjustment clip however you need to, whatever works best for you. So that should be pretty self-explanatory. If you wanted to add multiple layers of adjustment clips, if that's how you like to work, you can do that as well, of course. Just drag another one on. A cool tip about this little timeline viewer is that if you come over here, you can turn on and off all of these different layers so they won't actually show in your thumbnail view. So if I don't want all my A-roll clips to show, you see though that's grayed out. And then up here in the thumbnails, they don't show either. Now that we have adjustment clips out of the way, what are some more Resolve specific ways of quickly working through a project? I'm going to turn off the timeline viewer and just scroll to the first A-roll clip in my timeline. So I'm going to work on this one, and then I'm going to apply the corrections that I make on this to the rest of the A-roll clips. It's the simplest way that I know how to do it. I'm just going to make the same sort of corrections, and I'll probably just fast forward through this section, but I'm just going to apply a quick curves adjustment, apply more saturation, maybe a little more contrast, and then a little bit of an offset, something like that. Okay, say that looks good. It doesn't, but it does. I want to take that correction and apply it to the rest. Using what I just showed you, all of those clips are on video track one, so I'm just going to turn off video track two and video track three. So now that all I see here in the thumbnail viewer is all of the A-roll clips that I want to apply. Click on the first one, and I'm going to scroll to the last one and hold down shift, and then click on the last one, and that will highlight everything in between. All of these are selected. And then I'm going to right-click on the first one that has the correction on it. And then right here in the middle, it says Apply Grade. Click on that, and then it'll pop up with this Replace Existing Grades, and we'll hit Replace. And as you can see, it's applying that correction to all of the clips that are selected or highlighted. So let the computer catch up and do its thing. Another way you can do it, if I highlighted all those clips again, and middle mouse click on the clip that you want to apply the grade from, it will do the same thing. The middle mouse button has a lot of different functionality. Well, not a lot, but some functionality. If you don't have a mouse with a middle mouse button, I'd recommend getting one for Resolve. As long as you have your timeline organized with like A-roll clips on video track one and B-roll clips on video track two, this should be a pretty easy way to apply grades across the clips that you want to and exclude the ones that you don't want to. Enable video track two with all my B-roll on it for the most part. I'll show you one other way that you can easily apply grades across multiple clips. So I'm gonna click on this first one or whatever one and do a very simple correction. Something like that. Okay, once you've made corrections or grades to a clip, if you right click on the viewer and hit grab still, nothing will happen. Actually, something will happen. I'm gonna close that. And in the top left-hand corner is this little gallery button. Click on that gallery button, and you can see that it created this little thumbnail. And from this thumbnail, you can do the same thing if you right-click on it. Here, the third option is apply grades. So you can apply grades from these thumbnails. So I'm gonna click on my B-roll clip, the first one, and scroll to the last one, shift-click, right-click on the thumbnail, and apply grade. And there you go. The stills that we create only exist within the particular project that we're working in now, but there's a way to create a still that will carry through across all of your future projects that exist within the same database in Resolve. If you click down here on the home button, your databases are over here. If you just started in Resolve, you don't have to worry about these databases too much. You should only have one called local database.
all of the projects that you've created should be within that database. So that's all you really need to know about that. I'm gonna close that down, and I'm gonna create a very specific look that I want to use in future projects. It's gonna be that. If I grab a still here, it's gonna add it over into my gallery view, but these stills don't work in future projects. In order to get them to work in future projects, you need to create a power grade. And that's very simple. So right under here where it says gallery, there's this little switcher. We'll click that switcher, and now we have another option for power grade. And we'll click on that, and you can see there's no stills created, but I'll do the same thing, just right click and grab still. We have the stills that are created within just this project, and now we've got stills in the power grade that will carry through all the projects in our database. It doesn't have a very descriptive name. It's called 2.11.1, but if we right click, we can change label, and I'll just call this Smurf look. Cool beans. I'll come over to my little home button here, open up a different project. Got this beautiful clip, but I want it to be Smurf-like. So coming over here, the gallery is already open, and click on power grade, right click on it, and apply grade. Voila, beautiful Smurf look. You can right click it and apply grade, or you can middle mouse click it to apply the grade. The last easy method to apply grades across the entire timeline is to apply the grade across the entire timeline. Over here above your node graph, you have this little, these two little dots here, and then you also have this where it says clip and then a dropdown. If you click that dropdown, you've got the option for clip and timeline. And when I hit timeline, this little dot is going to highlight the right dot instead. Now we are in a timeline node graph, and you can do the same thing by just clicking on the dot. So now we're in the clip node graph. Now we're in the timeline node graph. Add a node. To do that, we're just going to hit Alt or Option and the S key, and that adds a node. And you can see this node looks a little different. It's outlined in blue as opposed to red. And whatever we do in this node graph is going to apply across the entire timeline. So I'm going to grab my offset and turn it blue. And now everything in my timeline is going to be blue. Hey, Smurfland. This would be a really great method for applying kind of your final look to your project. If you want to use a LUT or if you want to add a very stylized or specific kind of look, I would do this at the last. So I wouldn't do this to make corrections. I would make my corrections to the clips, and then I would use this timeline node graph to apply a very specific look at the end. But at any point, you can always come back to the individual clips by just clicking on this little button. And now we're back in our clip node graph, so we are specifically working on this individual clip and not the entire timeline. That's a really cool thing about Resolve, is that you actually have multiple layers of node graphs that you can apply. So you can always switch between, you know, your clips individually. You can make groups and grade groups together, and I'm going to show you that in a bit here if you're interested. And then, of course, you can do the timeline as a separate layer. Those are my quick and dirty tips. So if you're done with the video, I appreciate you watching. But if you want to know how you can set up your project at the beginning so that when you get to color, it works more quickly and efficiently, then that's what we're going to do now. What I want to show you here in the media page is how you can get your clips organized so that you can find them and group them together easily when you get to the color section. So in this little jumble of media, I have my talking head clip. One way to get organized is to color code your clips on the timeline, and you can easily do that. So if you have multiple talking head clips, you can select all of them right here. And when you have them all selected, you can come over here to the top right and click on the metadata. So you can easily change the color of your clips using clip color, and we'll make this navy. And then if I jump over into the timeline, since all these clips are already laid out here, you can see they're all navy because they all come from that same clip. I'm going to click on that again, and I'm going to add keyword. I'm just going to type in main, and I can type in a roll. That should be good. And then I'm also going to add a flag just for fun, and we'll make the flag lavender. And you can see right here on this clip that I have a little flag in the top left, a little lavender flag, and then a little circle, a little navy circle. So you can see that those have been applied. So I'm gonna go back over to this and then select my B-roll folder. My B-roll clips, I am going to highlight them all and add some keywords. We'll type in B-roll, and then I'm gonna change these to, let's say, orange, an orange flag. Now coming out into the edit page, now all of my B-roll clips that I highlighted in there are now orange. That's a very basic level of organization, but it's really gonna help out in organizing your color correction, color grading. What you can do, a couple things you can do, without making groups or anything like that, if you come up to where it says clips, this little dropdown, you have all these different options for showing clips based on some of those parameters that we just set up. So you can do keywords, and I only want to see my A roll. Now down here in my thumbnail viewer, the only clips that will be shown are those A roll clips that I tagged with that keyword. Alternatively, you can organize by clip color. Go back to all clips, and then clip color. Those should have been, what did I say, navy? Yeah, navy. There we go. So now all of the clips that were marked as navy or colored navy will show up. Now that I have all of my A-roll clips flagged and showing in the thumbnail viewer, I'm going to reset that for one. I'm going to highlight all of them. Well, shit, I'm going to highlight only the ones that haven't been, still don't have a grade on them or a correction on them. So highlight all those and then right click on one. And I'm going to add into a new group. Let's call it A-roll. Now I'm going to come back up to the clips dropdown, and I'm going to select keywords and then B-roll. So now my B-roll clips are showing. First one is highlighted, and I'm going to scroll to the last one and shift click. Now they're all highlighted. Right click, add into a new group, and I'll call this one B-roll. So now I've got two groups created. So now what do we do with these groups? If you remember from earlier, up here, we only had two dots to choose from and two options in this little dropdown. But now that we've created groups, we've got two more options. So we've got a group pre-clip, clip, group post-clip, and timeline. The one that we're concerned with is the group post-clip. So I'm gonna select that, and now our little node has changed to yellow. And whatever we do now in this group post clip is going to apply to all the clips in that group. I'm going to turn our friendly bag blue, and you can see that reflected in all of the clips in the thumbnail viewer. And if we go out to the edit page, the A roll has not been affected, only the B roll, only the ones that were selected and added into that group are now blue. And the great thing about working in groups is, just like in the timeline, you can go back to the clip node graph and only affect that individual clip that's selected. So this one here, if you wanted, if it had like a weird white balance or something that you don't want to affect the entire group, you can just adjust the white balance on that individual clip. The timeline node graph can be very daunting because maybe not everything is going to take the same look. It won't all play nicely. But you can do like a very specific look to all of the clips in a group and then do a different, very specific look to the clips in the other group or however many groups you want to create. That's it for the video. I hope it was helpful. I hope you learned something. Please let me know in the comments if there was anything that was unclear or any suggestions, etc. I do have a couple more videos on working in color in Resolve. One is how to convert log footage to Rec. 709, three different ways that you can do that. The other deals with nodes. If you're really confused about nodes in the color page, I'll walk you through three of the most commonly used nodes, why and how you might want to use them.